Hey y'all. Today I am going to do kind of a deep dive on how I make gravy, specifically the gravy that goes with my hamburger steaks and gravy. That recipe is on deepfriendhoney.com and I really go into the process. So if you need help with the hamburger part, refer to that. But for the gravy, which is the tough part, used to be for me and I know still is for some people, I wanted to focus on that. So it starts with your fats. I use some of the pan drippings along with the butter. Here I'm using 2 tablespoons of butter, and there was about half a tablespoon or so of pan drippings left in the pan, as well as some little pieces of minced onion that had fallen out of the hamburger. So after the butter is melted and it's mixed together with the pan drippings, I sprinkle the flour over the fat. I try to do it pretty evenly over the surface. That helps me distribute it in a little easier, I think. And then I like to use a flat whisk, like a roux whisk, but you don't have to, and that's why I specifically didn't use it. In this video, you can use a spoon, a spatula, whatever. The key is you want to really get the flour and the fat worked in together. There's a lot of foam in this because I'm using butter, but the heat is on medium. I don't take it above medium high when I'm making gravy. I don't take it above medium high in these hex club pans pretty much ever, but the heat for gravy stays at around medium. After the fat and flour is incorporated, mixed together, you want to keep stirring it the entire time so that it doesn't burn and you're letting it brown. You're going to let it deepen in color, not as dark as you would like a gumbo. We're not going to do this for 30, 45 minutes, but about 5 minutes or so, however dark you want it to get. Just don't burn it, so keep it moving. And then I add the liquid in batches. I'm using just water. I feel like the pan drippings and everything is good enough for me. You can use chicken broth, beef broth, whatever you want. But I like to make sure that it's warm when I'm gonna add it to gravy, and I add it in batches. I add it about half at a time, and I stir in all of the liquid before I add in that next batch of liquid. And then it's just a matter of really getting it mixed in there. There shouldn't be any lumps because you got the fat and the flour mixed together really well before you started adding the liquid, and then you added the liquid in batches. So doing it bit by bit is key. Now, your ratio as far as fat to flour to liquid has a lot to do with the consistency of your gravy. Generally, I do 2 tablespoons of flour, 2 tablespoons of fat, and about a cup and a quarter of liquid. That makes about 2 cups of gravy. If you like it thinner, you'll add more liquid. If you like it thicker, you'll add less. And you just double it. If you want to make, twice as much gravy, keep increasing it. I didn't let this gravy or the roux brown completely because I wanted to show you the addition of browning. That is kitchen bouquet. Browning is just really burnt sugar and it adds color, but you don't want to use too much because it can throw off the flavor. So you saw that I added like literally a drop and it added just a deeper tone to this. So now it's like a caramel peanut butter color. And it's done. I just add in my hamburger back, let that simmer together until the hamburger is completely cooked through, and I'm finished. My recipe for hamburger steaks and gravy with fried onions is on deepfriendhoney.com, and it's linked in the description box, as well as a link to the hex club pan. But as always, thank you for watching. Have a good one. Bye.